Hello, my name is Eric Tarr. In this video, I'll provide an overview to the Waves API 560 Equalizer plugin. First, I'll demonstrate the spectral processing characteristics and then let you hear it in action. This plugin is modeled after the API 560 hardware equalizer. It is a 10-band graphic EQ, which means that there are 10 separate peaking or bell-shaped filters with fixed frequency but variable amplitude. The frequencies of the 560 are spaced out in octave increments, which means from one band to the next, the frequency is either doubled or halved. Let me demonstrate the plugin now by making use of the Waves Q clone to visualize the spectral curve. Here, you can see as I increase the amplitude of the 1K band, the bell-shaped curve shows up in Q clone. This is also true for any of the other bands as well. One interesting thing to know about the API 560 is that each bell-shaped curve has proportional Q, or bandwidth. This means that the bandwidth is wide when there's a small change in amplitude, and the bandwidth is narrow when there's a large change in amplitude. Here, you can see that when I change the amplitude by a small amount, the 3 dB down point is wider than when I change the amplitude by a large amount. Here, the 3 dB down point is much narrower. This allows for a wide range of flexibility with the plugin, as a 560 is capable of very smooth shaping as well as very dramatic equalization. The interaction between adjacent bands also opens up a wide range of creative possibilities. Let me demonstrate how the plugin sounds using a lead vocal. Here, I'll make use of some of the included presets with the plugin. The stars won't shine in the city without you, love. I said, ooh, I'll take you, make you feel pretty, but I need you, love. I need your love. The stars won't shine in the city without you, love. I said, ooh, I'll take you, make you feel pretty, but I need you, love. I need your love. The stars won't shine in the city without you, love. I said, ooh, I'll take you, make you feel pretty, but I need.
Notice that the plugin adds a fullness to the low end and a clarity to the upper mids, without ever sounding harsh. The last controls to show you on the plugin are the output gain control, the polarity invert switch, and the ability to turn on and off the analog modeling. I'll play it out now and let you hear the plugin work its magic.